Dr. Bowen, Mr. President and Vice President. Welcome to this presentation. I would like to give a warm welcome to the Director of the Forensic Psychiatric Institution in Kosovo, Mr. Gani Haliljar, and Mr. Sokol Zobel, the General Deputy Director of the Ministry of Justice, and representatives of the Ministry of Health. And I would like to thank them for the contribution that they have given to this project. I'm Margarita Jolzai, a senior student at Economics and Management Concentration. The presentation for today for this project is about Kosovo's forensic psychiatric institution and its challenges on management, procedures of treatment, and finances. The Kosovo Forensic Psychiatric Institution is an institution which deals with the assessment, expertise, and treatment of the mentally ill offenders. A mentally ill offender is considered a person who has committed a crime, but he or she cannot stand to court sessions because of the mental condition that he or she possesses. As a result, in many countries in the world, and especially in Europe, in the developed countries, they have created institutions which deal specifically with this issue. The problem that this project tries to address is that the institution is new in Kosovo, which has never been done before, and as a result, it faces some challenges because of the lack of the experience and lack of the professional staff. The main goals of this project, which I tried to solve, are first of all to identify the problems that the institution is facing, the actors involved in it, and also the institutions and ministries. And the first goal was accomplished through also secondary research and financial statement analysis. The subsequent goal was to propose solutions to stakeholders which impact the communication process, which then leads to a good or bad procedure of treatment, which then we can see the impact also in the budget and also the lack of professional or preparation of the professional staff of the institution. The methodology used in this project is mainly primary and secondary data. The problems were identified through secondary data, scholars' work and research, also financial statements of the institution and other reports of the institution and the Ministry of Health and Ministry of Justice. After the problems were identified, then we went to the primary data, which included three interviews with representatives of Ministry of Health and Ministry of Justice, and also the director of the institution of Kosovo. Then, in order to back up this information that we got from the interviews, a survey was done to the 30 professional employees of the institution, which included the doctors, the nurses, and everyone involved in the professional staff. Forensic mental health in Europe and the forensic psychiatry as a term was first present 200 years ago, so it has a long history. However, as a specialty within psychiatry or within medicine, it wasn't developed until after World War I and World War II, because these two wars left countries destroyed and divided. After these two wars, a high number of mental illnesses was prevailing in the countries in Europe, and also the crime rates have increased. And as a result, many countries decided that they should have a special institution, and these individuals should not be treated in general hospitals or in prisons because of the lack of the expertise in these prisons, and also because of the lack of capacity to fit all the individuals who are mentally ill and all the individuals who are mentally ill and have committed offenses. As an example, you can see the structure which is present in Belgium. I specifically chose Belgium because Belgium, including Austria and Finland, have helped Kosovo in order to draft and implement the project of the institution. And in Belgium, the procedure is much simpler compared to other countries. The procedure of treatment of the mentally ill offenders is protected by the Social Protection Act, which says that any individual who has committed a crime and is suspected to be mentally ill, they cannot be found criminally responsible. So in order to decide this, first of all, we need an expert assessment, which is provided by the specific forensic institution in Belgium. After that decision is sent to the judge, if the expert says that the person is mentally ill, then the judge decides whether he or she has committed a crime. If they have committed a crime, then they go straightly to the forensic psychiatric institution. If not, they go to a general hospital or mental health center. Whereas if the expert says that the person is not mentally ill and they have committed the crime, then they go directly to prison. In Kosovo, forensic psychiatry has started to develop after the war in 1999. The reasons behind this are that the war left many people with after-war trauma and stress. According to the Kosovo Center for Rehabilitation, in Kosovo, 64.9% of the population have suffered from trauma after the war. In this trauma, the main diseases that have appeared in the population are the post-traumatic stress disorder, the emotional distress, and depression. The mental health care services before the institution was established were mainly done in the general hospitals and in prisons. However, there was not a coherent communication between these two, because the prison said that we lack the professional staff to treat them, whereas the hospital said that we do not have enough capacity because we have our own patients, who are patients with a mental abnormal condition, but who have not committed a crime. And as you can see from the table, these are the number of beds in all of the general hospitals and prisons, and also the Shtime Special Institute, it has 54 beds in total. However, they are only for the people who are mentally ill, but who have not committed a crime. And in the last column, you can see that the Special Forensic Institution, which is the institution that this project is dealing with, has a total of 36 beds, which 6 beds are for the assessment period and 30 beds are for the treatment periods. As I mentioned earlier, the development of the institution of the forensic psychiatry started after the war, more specifically in 2004 with the EMIC regulation 2004/34 on criminal proceedings involving perpetrators with a mental disorder. It not only supported the rights of the mentally ill, but it also supported their process of trial, whether they can be held criminally responsible or not, depending on the degree of their crime or illness. Afterwards, the Ministry of Justice and Ministry of Health, they drafted a project, and they said that we need a special institution for this case because of the lack of resources, because of the lack of beds, because of the lack of professional staff, and also because they had the support of the law. As a result, in the Kosovo Strategy of Mental Health for the years 2008 and 2013, the Ministry of Health drafted this project and included it in this strategy. After that, the European Commission chose a forensic institution from outside, from Europe, and specifically a developed country. So they chose the Finnish National Institute for Health and Welfare, which is from Finland. They provided the specialists in order to train the staff who were going to be included in the institution. They went through a 9-month period of training, and 30 employees of the institution were included in this training. The institution is funded by the European Commission, is managed by the European Union Office in Kosovo, and is implemented by the Finnish National Institute for Health and Welfare in cooperation with the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Justice. The beneficiaries and supporters of this whole project are the Ministries of Health, Justice, Kosovo Judicial Council, and the Psychiatric Clinic of the University Clinical Center of Kosovo. During the interviews and during the secondary research, it was found that the main problems that the institution is facing are in management, in procedures of treatment, and in finances. In management, they lacked public relations or information about the public. They lacked marketing and advertising. However, the most important point that the representatives mentioned is that they lacked the professional staff. It is obvious that they do lack the professional staff because in Kosovo there was no demand for such a profession, since all of the treatment was done in general hospitals and prison. And as a result of the inexistent demand, there was no such, there were no professional staff in this field. As we can see from the map, the institution has doctors, psychologists, social workers, nurses, and kinds of nurses. But in order to be more specified for this treatment and project, they went through a 9-month training with a specialist from Finland. However, not all of them did. Only 26 out of 30 did go through this training. 4 of them did not, which includes 2 nurses and 1 doctor. The reason behind this is that these 4 people were employed after the training was accomplished. When asked whether they think that the training was enough, 22 of them said that the training was not enough, so they could not fulfill all of their daily duties only based on that training. They needed more. And when asked whether they had visited a similar institution outside of Kosovo, 24 of them said that they did not visit a similar institution, whereas 6 of them said that they did. In order to draft the recommendations and the proposal of solutions for this project, they were asked a question about what they think that the long-term solution for expanding their skills would be. I was specifically asked this question because they are the people who are most involved with the patients and with the daily problems that they face. So they know the best what they need in order to establish their skills. The highest voted option, the highest ranked option from them was a visit to a similar institution on site, and then they asked for a forensic psychiatry department in UP and also longer training periods for them and the future staff. Regarding the procedures of treatment, when they were asked about the areas which affect more the procedures of treatment, they answered that the treatment material, the lack of treatment materials is the field which actually affects mostly the procedural treatment and also the budget and communication. However, treatment material and budget will be discussed in the finances office, in the finances, sorry, section, and the communication will be discussed in this section of the procedural treatment. When asked about the communication between Ministry of Health and Ministry of Justice and in which field they lack the support to the institution, the highest ranked option is that the Ministry of Justice, the one in red, they lack the information about the existence of the institution, whereas the Ministry of Health lacks the provision of resources, which is a detail of the Ministry of Health, for the functioning of the institution. During the interviews and during the service, this graph was created. Actually, Forensic Psychiatric Institution has its own graph, but this is a much more simplified way. It shows how the procedural treatment would go if there were no gaps in communication and if the process would go as it should. These yellow stars, they show the gap where the gaps in communication are, and as we can see, the lawyer, the prosecutor, and the judge, they lack the information, or they don't know that they have the possibility to send an individual for assessment in the institution. When a person is suspected to have committed a crime and to be mentally ill, he or she is firstly sent in the detention or in the pretrial center. In there, the judge has to decide whether he or she should be sent in the institution in order to be assessed for a mental illness disorder. If the judge decides that the person should be sent, then they send it to the institution, which is point one in the graph. And when expertise gives the decision, sometimes the judge takes too much time to decide whether that person should go to the correctional center or whether that person should go for treatment, and as a result it causes losses in budget for the institution because they have to keep these individuals longer, and having in mind their problems with the budget, this is not a good sign for the institution. So they send the person back again to detention, which is going to go to point one. When the judge makes the decision, and if the expert says that the person was not ill, has committed the crime, then they send it to point three, which is the correctional center or the prison. If the expert decides that the person is ill and they have committed a crime, then they send them to the psychiatric mandatory treatment, which is point two. When that individual finishes his or her treatment period, then if they have a sentence higher than 5 years, they will be sent in the correctional center, which is point three. If they have a detention less than 5 years, then they will be sent in the mental health center after they have finished their treatment. However, if they don't have any detention, but they have committed a minor offense, after finishing the treatment, they are sent in freedom. The main problem that the institution has is with the finances, because the finances lead to the lack of treatment materials, to the lack of providing of information, and also to the lack of communication between the ministries. When asked about the areas which are affected most by the insufficient amount of the finances, they said that they had to reduce the staff, and they said that they had to reduce the salaries and the materials and drugs, which are the three highest ranked options in this case. The budget for salaries was one of the main points in the lack of finances. The first table, we can see that this is the planned budget by the institution in its initial phases, before they had information about what kind of resources the Ministry of Health provide. So they planned that they will have 137,000 euros for the salaries of the professional staff. However, the Ministry of Health decided that they will only give 86,000 euros for budget for salaries to the institution. And as a result, in table number two, we can see that they had to decrease the number of nurses, which is number six, from 29 to 17. However, they increased the number of doctors from 3 to 6, and they decreased the wages for 200 to 300 euros, and they reached the 86,000 euros that the Ministry of Health provided. However, that was only for the professional staff, when you talk about the administrative and logistics staff, the head of administration, legal officer, etc., in a sum of 16,000 euros for a period of 6 months, all of them are transferred from the Kosovo Clinical and Hospital Service because the Ministry of Health and the institution did not have the necessary means to provide for this staff. Also, for the goods and services, the institution planned that they would need 205,000 euros. However, the Ministry of Justice said that they would provide only 165,000 euros, whereas the Ministry of Health would provide 10,000 euros for municipal services. But the Ministry of Justice did not provide these resources because the stakeholders and also the involvement of this ministry was not clear in the institution, and as such, they decided to allocate these resources elsewhere. So the Ministry of Health had to find a solution, and they provided 60,000 euros for this, for the goods and services, and most of the treatment materials and other materials that the institution needs are transferred from the prison health system or from Kosovo Clinical and Hospital Center. Having in mind all of these problems that the institution was facing, the project tried to give some solutions or recommendations in order for future improvements. I would like to start with the lack of professional staff because this is what makes the main function of the institution. If there would be no professional staff for proper treatment of the individuals, then the actual function of the institution would not be complete. As a result, I decided that the best way would be to introduce a new department of forensic psychiatry within the University of Pristina. This would require several steps. First of all, they would need to hire foreign professors for 2 months in order to keep the intensive lectures and also to train the other professors in how it should be done. The total cost, these are just approximate costs in order to know the approximate cost that they would need to allocate for this accommodation, so 20,000 euros. For other professors from Kosovo, it's 30,000 euros, and they would also be transferred from the current professors that are in the medicine department within the University of Pristina. We also plan to send 3 students per year for a visit abroad in a similar institution since the staff asked that. So the total cost for these students is 15,000 euros for a 10-day training outside. It's 500 euros per day per person. We also plan to create some facilitators or trainers which would then train the other staff members and professors in regards to the procedure of treatment and everything that's involved in the institution. So the patient facilitators would be 24,000 euros for the training period and 6,000 euros per year for 2 facilitators would be the increase in wages for 250 euros per month. So the total is 30,000 euros. And also the visit abroad for the 2 facilitators in order to see how the process goes is 10,000 euros. So the total for this recommendation is 105,000 euros. Next, for the procedure of treatment, what it should be done is there should be an increased awareness between the ministries in order to increase the communication. The stakeholders should be clear, the involvement of each stakeholder should be clear, and also the information regarding the existence and importance of the institution should be made clear. The institution is the highest level to refer to when regarding the mental health of offenders, and that should be made clear to both ministries and to the judicial council. So we plan to hold 2 main central events or workshops. The first one would be an informative workshop about the existence and importance of the institution, whereas the second one would be a feedback and implementation and the feedback about the lessons learned during the first informative session. In the upcoming years, there will be only one workshop. The total cost for these 2 workshops is 7,000 euros. Regarding the budget, the project decided that there should be an accommodation of the budget in accordance to the fundamental needs of the institution. However, they should also have in mind the possibilities that the Ministry of Justice and the Ministry of Health have in order to achieve this. First of all, for the professional staff, the project decided that they should have an increase in wages, slight increase in wages in order to increase their commitment. However, they should also increase the number of doctors. And we came to the conclusion that the total cost for this staff is 146,000 euros. The administrative staff should remain the same and the wages should remain the same. However, they should be completely transferred to the institution and the budget should be provided by the institution and not by another service, because that might lead to lax in commitment by the staff because they don't feel that they want to do it. For the goods and services, it should be made an accommodation between the institution and the ministries. So they have planned to have 200,000 euros, but they should find the middle ground. So the Ministry of Justice should provide the 165,000 that they promised, and the Ministry of Health should provide the $10,000 that they promised, or they should find a solution between the central government in order to provide the solution. Because without the treatment materials and without all of the materials that they need, the institution could not be the institution that it is. In conclusion, the previous treatment of these individuals was done in general hospitals and in prisons. However, this led to an intervening communication between them because of the lack of professional staff and the lack of capacity to treat them. And as a result, there was no demand for experts, and there was a lack of experts. Also, it was seen that there was a lack of communication because the involvement of the stakeholders was not clear. And the financial resources led to other problems, which are the treatment materials, because both ministries could not provide what they promised. According to these recommendations, they should be made clear the role of the forensic psychiatric institution in Kosovo, and it should be made clear that it is the highest level to refer to when regarding to the treatment of the mentally ill offenders. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, please. Much more detailed information and tables which led to these calculations in the project. And if you want to see the project, I would be most happy to give it to you, so you have more detailed information there.
You told us a lot more about the staffing needs and professional needs. Could you tell us what sort of numbers are projected? How many patients or offenders each year would be needing this sort of help?
Yes. Currently, in this initial 6-month period, they have only 6 patients, and they are in the initial phases of assessment, so they have not yet reached the phases of treatment, because either the experts have not given their expertise or their assessment, or the judge has not made the decision whether they should continue the treatment in the institution, or whether they should go to correctional centers or medical or general hospitals. What they project to have each year, so the capacity that they have is 36 beds. 6 beds are for the assessment period, and 30 beds are for the treatment period. So this is what they initially have in hand.
And what sort of offenses have they committed?
The individuals that currently are in this institution are suspected to have committed the offenses of murder, attempted murder, or kidnapping. However, we can also find family violence, sexual violence, etc.
So, are you suggesting the finances of this institute should be totally independent? Because I keep thinking, you know, when you explain it, is the main responsibility from the Ministry of Health or the Ministry of Justice? Because both are obviously heavily involved.
Yes. So this was the main problem, the unclear involvement of both ministries. So both ministries, it was actually more dealing with the Ministry of Health because of the health condition. However, the Ministry of Justice should also be involved because there is the Judicial Council who makes the decision. It is the judge. So the Ministry of Justice is involved. What I recommended is that through those workshops, the involvement of each institution and of each ministry should be made clear in order for them to know how much resources they can provide, in order for them to know that it is their responsibility to provide the resources, because their employees and their departments are also involved in the institution.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, thank you very much.